Hello there, it's Lenny McGill with the GlockStore Performance and Custom Shop right here in San Diego, California. Today we're going to go ahead and talk about a little part that is not very well known. It's not a part that actually comes with the gun, but it's a part that many Glock armorers are familiar with, and if you're not familiar with it, it's rather interesting. This is it. It's a slide cover plate that is orange in color, of course, that's the one thing you can notice, but it's also half size. It's called an armorer's slide cover plate for a reason. Because when you put this on, it'll allow you to look inside the gun and to see the type of connection the striker or firing pin is having with the trigger bar, the cruciform of the trigger bar. It allows you to troubleshoot some of the problems as to maybe why a gun is malfunctioning or what is the status of the gun. Does it need to be upgraded? Does the striker need to be replaced? Does the trigger bar need to be replaced? And I'll show you how it works here in just a second. So let's go ahead through the disassembly procedure of the slide cover plate. Now, first of all, this is a Glock 17 Gen 4. This procedure works on all Glocks that use the same slide cover plate. Of course, the gun's empty, no magazine. I'll double check inside the chamber, no rounds inside the chamber. Pull the trigger in a safe direction, keeping my finger always, you know, aware of where the trigger is and you know, the fact that I want to always keep that gun pointed in a safe direction. Now, there's no ammunition in the gun itself, no ammunition on this table, no ammunition in this room, so I have no chance of inadvertently loading this gun and having an accidental discharge. Most accidents happen right here at this kind of phase where you're cleaning, maintaining, installing new parts. So be well aware of the fact that it's important that you double check that the gun is in fact unloaded. That said, here's how we're going to go ahead and approach this. You don't even have to take the gun apart. We're going to go ahead and lock the slide back with the slide stop lever. And we're going to gain access to the slide cover plate by looking underneath there. And you're going to notice, first thing you'll see is the striker lug or firing pin lug that's sitting down there. It's silver. Underneath that is a little black piece of plastic. So let me lift that up real quick. Boom. And that black piece of plastic is called the spacer sleeve. That spacer sleeve runs up and actually intersects with the slide cover plate, the underside of it, and it's spring pressure, so it's pushing up on that slide cover plate. And if I really can't take the slide cover plate off without reducing the pressure on that spring. If I do, I've got to claw at it and you know, make it pretty ugly. And you know, people call us all the time and say, well, I had trouble getting it off there and I really scratched it up. And yes, you will, but if you follow this procedure, you won't. So you take a punch. This is our front sight takedown tool. You'll see that it's got a front sight wrench on it, and then it has the standard 3/32 inch punch. Come underneath here, and underneath the actual firing pin lug, that spacer sleeve is spring loaded, so I can push down on that. See how it springs back up? I'm going to push down on that, keep it down, and then thumb this off, keeping care to keep my thumb over top of the hole there so nothing flies out. There are some spring loaded items in here, so I don't want to lose anything. And there you go. So if we look inside there, there's that spacer sleeve we talked about, and that is the extractor depressor plunger bearing, I think is what it is. It's a little piece of plastic that's stuck inside of a spring that's stuck to a steel rod that runs all the way down here. You can actually see the steel rod itself right there. And that's the extractor depressor plunger. And that's the actual extractor. So that all runs up and down here, and sometimes people will lose that little piece of plastic. In the 9mm, it's black. In the 40 caliber, it's white. In the 45, it's green. So this just happens to be a black one because it's a Glock 17. All right, so that said, now I don't even have to do anything else here because now I'm just going to replace the factory slide cover plate with the half or armorer's slide cover plate that's in orange. And to do so, I'm going to go ahead and kind of preload it up here. And I'll use the fat side of this big punch just to push down this spacer sleeve. And then walk this thing up there. And then I'll use the punch side to push down the extractor depressor plunger there. And boom. And I think I got it up there. I don't think I got a good push on that here. Let me go ahead and take my little hammer and just tap it in there. I didn't release it properly. Now, what's nice about this hammer is that it is nylon, and I can kind of bang on it and not have any problems. And looks like it's good. Look, it's a little bit goofy, though. I don't know what I did to that thing. Typically, you don't have to do that. Now it's better. It was kind of crooked for some reason. I don't think I got a good push on that, but it's now seated properly. Okay, that's what it looks like, seated properly. Now, what's gonna be cool about this is that when I close the gun up, I can look inside. Now, it's gonna be hard for you to see there, but if we zoom in really close, and there you go. See, there's the striker lug, that big shiny piece, and it's intersecting with the trigger. If I pull the trigger, watch what happens here. See how that striker went forward? Yeah, that's what we're trying to show you. That's not bad. I got a little bit of light in there. I'm good. I'm actually glad about that. And so I'll show it to you again. There's the striker. And now what we're trying to see the connection of the striker. You can also see the connector right there too. See the little connector is only going to be on your right side, right over here. Oops. Right over here, right here. That little piece right there is a connector. It's sticking up kind of bent. All right. So watch what happens when I pull the trigger and watch the connector move. When I rack the slide, the connector is going to move back now. See if I can show it to you. See how the connector kind of went bump, bump, okay? Well, that's what your objective is to look inside there and see the connection that the striker lug is making with the trigger bar. And the armorer's class, the Glock armorer's class, recommends that you have at least 2/3 of the trigger bar onto the actual lug of the striker. So we don't want it to be down there where it's just a little bit. Now it's a real thin little piece of steel, but you need to have some coverage on there, so we don't want it to slip off inadvertently. So about 2/3 at least, if not the full thing. So looking in here, I can see that I've got a pretty good coverage. It's a brand new gun, and I wouldn't expect to have anything go bad. But when you, like I said, when you squeeze the trigger, you actually see that motion there, and you see everything, you see what happens. And what's really good here, I'm gonna see if you can look in here. So you see how the striker is being pulled back as I pull the trigger? That's that big load that you get with the Glock trigger. That's why people don't like the Glock trigger. So there's so much play before anything happens. Now, as I get back here, you're going to see the striker's, the bar is going to fall off the striker. And so, see the bar right there? Just falling off? And boom, there it goes forward. And that's the motion you're looking for. So an armorer will put this piece on there, look inside there, and say, okay, I see what's happening. I get it. You know, and they'll say, your trigger bar is bent, your trigger bar is worn, the striker's worn. They're going to look inside. They're going to say, well, what's happening there? What kind of connection do we have? Okay, yeah, I've got a good connection. I've got bad connection. Here, I've got at least 90%, maybe 90 or 85% coverage of the bar on the striker. And as I squeeze, you'll see this right here. And this is where I'm hoping you can get in here one last time. And, boy, you really just don't see it. Yeah, it's the bar, the trigger bar itself, the cruciform will fall off and the striker goes forward. But you saw the striker go forward, and that's the main thing. So that's what this armorer's plate's all about, to give you a look inside to see, you know, how the parts are actually working while the gun is fully assembled. And it's a really inexpensive item. It's a fun thing to have. It's actually valuable if you're in the Glock business, because that's a good way to be able to see, you know, what's happening in there. It's an inexpensive piece, and just something that anybody who is either a Glock armorer or a Glock fan should have, one of these half orange armorer's Slicker plates. I'm Lenny McGill. This, of course, is the Glock Store. Glock Store Performance and Custom Shop right here in San Diego. If you are ever in Southern California, I invite you to drop in and check out our retail store. Thanks for watching.